All right, let's dive in. Today, we're going to be financial detectives. We're going to solve a puzzle by uncovering a hidden message that the market is sending us. And we'll do it just by looking at the price of one single bond.
I mean, seriously, what if an asset's price wasn't just a number, but a whole story? A story about what might happen in the future, filled with all the market's hopes and fears. Well, that's exactly what we're going to learn how to do today.
And here it is. This is our central mystery. You see two bonds here. One is a super safe government bond, priced at 113. The other is a corporate bond, priced way down at just 45.2. Now, here's the thing. They were issued at the same time and promised the exact same future payments. So what gives? Why is one so much cheaper?
The answer, in one word, is risk. You see, the market thinks there are two very different roads this company could go down, and all that uncertainty is baked right into that $45.20 price tag. So let's break down what those two possible futures actually are. It's really that simple. Path number one, the company hits a rock patch and defaults on its debt. It can't pay. Path number two, everything goes great, and the company makes every single payment, right on time, in full. The bond's price today is just a blend of those two possibilities. Now, if the company defaults, it doesn't mean investors lose everything. They get what's called a recovery rate. In our case, it's 25%. But 25% of what? Well, it's 25% of the adjusted debt, which is just a fancy way of saying the bond's true risk-free value. And that's where our government bond comes in. That 113 price, that's our benchmark for the full risk-free value. So if the company goes under, investors get 25% of 113. Do the math, and that comes out to exactly 28.25. This is the payout in the bad scenario. Remember that number.
And a good scenario? Well, if the company makes all its payments, investors get the full value, which is our benchmark amount, the same as the government bond, 113. So the two potential payouts we're working with are 28.25 and 113.
Okay, so we have the price today, and we have the two possible payouts in the future. How do we connect them? This is where it gets really cool. We're going to build a simple equation that shows how today's price is basically a weighted average of those two futures. This right here is the absolute key to the whole thing. The price of 45.2 isn't just some random number. It is a precisely calculated balance, weighted by what the entire market believes the chances are for each of those outcomes.
Let's start building the formula. The first piece of the price comes from that default scenario. It's the probability of the default happening times the money you'd get back, which we already figured out is 28.25.
And here's the full picture. We just add the other side of the coin, the probability of getting paid in full, times that full payout of 113. The sum of these two weighted possibilities has to equal the price today. So think about it. We have almost all the pieces of the puzzle, except the probabilities themselves.
Now we just plug in the numbers. We know today's price is 45.2. Let's just use the letter P for the probability of default. Now, if the chance of default is P, then the chance of not defaulting has to be 1 minus P, right? And just like that, we have one clean equation with only one thing we don't know.
So, we have our equation. We have our mission. All that's left is a little bit of algebra to solve this thing. Let's find out what P actually is.
This is it. All of the market's hopes, fears, and complex analysis are all boiled down into this one single letter. By figuring out P, we are literally decoding the market's secret message about this company's future.
And there it is. When you solve for P, it comes out to 0.8. Or, put another way, 80%. The market is pricing this bond as if there is an 80% chance that this company is going to default. Wow, that is a massive number.
So we did the math, we got our number, but what does this 80% really tell us? This isn't just a textbook exercise. This number is a powerful, direct message from the collective mind of the entire market.
So here are the big takeaways. First, the market is screaming that this company is in serious trouble. Second, this 80% isn't one analyst's opinion. It's the weighted average of every buyer and seller out there. Third, this gives us a hard number for just how much risk people think they're taking on. And finally, you can use this exact same logic to figure out the hidden probabilities in all sorts of other risky assets, not just bonds.
And this brings us to the final and most important question. The market is flashing a giant warning sign saying there's an 80% chance of failure. So as an investor, do you see that warning and run for the hills? Or if you've done your own research and you think the market has it wrong, is this a massive, undervalued opportunity? And that, right there, is the art of investing. Thanks for joining me.